Let's begin the year right. Let's begin the year with health. You know, God wants you healthy. I believe in healing, in divine healing, of course, and I go to the world and travel and preach the gospel, and I will continue doing that till the day God takes me home. I also believe in health because the scripture says, I wish above all things you prosper and be in health. Dr. Wallach is back. You know, we've had so many people enjoy you so much. I said, you know what? I'm going to have the doctor back because so many people have ordered your books and your CDs, and they're talking about you. Doc, you've caused quite a stir, and I love it. What is it about you that people like? I mean, is it your personality, your age, the
Probably
way you
not.
Talk? What is it?
Probably not. You have the personality, Pastor.
Oh, I think you do. No. But anyways, I mean, you have caused such a stir, Doc.
Well, I think it's the message. And, of course, you know, it's biblical. My people are destroyed for lack of
knowledge. Of course, yeah.
Yes, of course. And so this is a message that's thousands and thousands and thousands of years old. This is a message that goes back to the beginning of time. And there are certain peoples that prospered health-wise. And why did God, it was always fascinating to me, Pastor Benny, why did God pick the Garden of Eden? Of all the places on earth, why did he pick that place to put Adam? And when you evaluate that, when you really look at it, that was not just any place. That was the most fertile place on earth. It was the most fertile place on earth. And why was that? Well, it's because it's surrounded by mountains. And the four rivers, the Tigris, the Euphrates, the Pishon, Dishon rivers, are bringing all this silt from the mountains down, was constantly refertilizing that soil. He picked them
up. That's amazing. You know, now, Doc, you know, today we see young people dying with cancer. Mm. I mean, you know, please understand this, precious partners. You know, I've gone to the world, I've preached the gospel around the world, and I have seen more sickness in the last 40 years of my life than I think any man alive. You know, and I love to see the power of God, but what really shakes me is sometimes I'll see someone who was healed 5 years ago, they're sick again with something else. And is it because they're not eating right? It has to be. Or is it something else?
Well, it's basically tied to what you eat and what you don't eat. Again, why did God pick the Garden of Eden to put Adam? Unfortunately, the nutritional elements that we need to maximize our lifespan, to live to be 120 as God commanded, and man's year shall be 120, that means that's a command. It shall be. That wasn't say, well, if you do right, you'll get there. And so what we have to do is understand that the nutritional minerals that we require as a human being, as a vertebrate, like a hummingbird or a man or an elephant, do not occur in equal and the same amounts over the crust of the earth. They occur in veins like chocolate and chalk ripple ice cream. When you look at the top 20 longevity cultures, interestingly enough, they're very faithful people. These are all people of God who live the longest. And by, you assume, either guidance or dumb luck, one or the other, probably a combination of dumb luck and guidance. They listened and they were guided to these places to live. They have everything they need to live to be 120. There's actually a cover article in the May 2013 National Geographic. It's a little girl, and it says, this girl will live to be 120. It just blows your mind because she happened to live in a place that has all the nutrients necessary to live to be 120. Now, her peoples didn't know that. They didn't analyze the soil, but they were guided by God to live there.
Okay, but how, I mean, you know, here we are living in big cities. We're not living in Eden or places like that girl is. How do we stay healthy? You see young people dying with cancer, diabetes, heart disease at young ages. I mean, that's shocking how many young people are suddenly getting these diseases that what it used to be that the older people got years ago.
Exactly.
Why?
Well, because they bet on the wrong horse.
What do you mean they bet on the wrong horse?
They bet on the wrong horse. They went with the medical system instead of God.
Keep talking, please. Okay. I want to hear that.
Instead of God. Because if we would listen to God, then we would be doing all the right things. We would be doing all the right things that our body needs. When we went with the medical system, that's when things began to become destroyed. Because the medical system went all with pharmaceuticals. And Pastor Benny, if you look at the PDR, the physician's desk reference, it has 250,000 prescription drugs in it. With the exception of antibiotics, which can kill pneumonia, can kill strep throat, can cure things, with the exception of antibiotics, there's not a single pharmaceutical in the PDR, the physician's desk reference, that cures anything. Doctors are not under any command to cure a disease even when there's cures available. So they choose to treat you. If they treat you for 25 years, they might make $750,000 per person. If they cure you, they make $300.
Yeah, exactly. And there is no money in health.
There's no money in cure. There's no money.
That's correct.
And so I'm interested in God's stuff. I call it God's stuff. And over the years, since I was 9 years old, and I know that God had to be part of this because a 9-year-old kid doesn't figure this out. And so when I figured it out when I was 9, it had to be a divine appointment. That's the only thing I can think of. And so over these years, I've treated it as such and learned everything I could, and I shared.
I mean, nutrition really works.
Of course.
You know, I am convinced because it happened to me myself. But there's some amazing programs out there like Forks Over Knives and Food Matters. And today you're seeing, this thing proven over and over. That the medicines people take is not really helping them. Like you said, they don't cure anything.
They relieve symptoms, which make people temporarily comfortable.
And the side effects are so horrible. You know, I was watching a commercial day before yesterday about some new pill, something, and they give you all the side effects that could happen to you if you take it right on that commercial, which of course they have to. And I thought to myself, why take it?
Well, people are
the risk of this and the risk of that. You may end up dying just from the side effects.
Oh, absolutely. That's one of the biggest side effects of these pharmaceuticals is death. Now, here's...
How many people die a year in America from side effects?
Of drugs?
If you
use drugs alone, 500,000.
In the United States?
Yes.
Every year?
Every year. That's a yearly figure. And the bigger figure is...
From side effects?
Of drugs.
Yes,
when you look at the bigger figure of side effects of treatments and side effects of care and lack of care from the directly attributed to doctors, not even washing their hands, simple things like that, is 15 million a year in America are killed, injured, and infected each year by doctors, killed, injured in their workplace. They don't even get an OSHA ticket. There's no consequences. So we have to spend more time considering God's direction than doctors' direction. That's why I say they bet on the wrong.
Okay, now listen, let me ask you, why... Well, let me just go back and ask, how do we prevent cancer in children, in young people, or any person? What do we do?
Okay, there's two things we have to do, Pastor Benny. Number one, we have to stop the bad stuff. Number two, we have to do the good stuff. I mean, you got to attack it from both ends. The good stuff, of course, is the 90 essential nutrients. We've known this, gosh, in the animal industry for 100 years. We've eliminated 900 different diseases in animals that still plague people. We've eliminated every birth defect you can name and 10 times that many you can't in animals that still plague people. Because what we did, we didn't have health insurance for animals, so we just had to fix the problems. On the other hand, we've been given a lot of misinformation on how to cook, how to eat, and this is killing us. For instance, Steve Jobs, billionaire, very smart guy, very smart guy. When it came to marketing, when it came to techie stuff.
Absolutely.
He died at 56 years of age. The doctors killed him as sure as they shot him in the head.
Are you sure on that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He was because of doctors?
Yes.
That he died?
Yes.
Oh, well, how's that?
Okay, well, first of all, he was an unsupplemented vegan. If you want to be a vegan, you can be a very successful vegan, but you have to supplement with the 90 essential nutrients because you can't get it in the food because they don't occur in an equal blanket around the crust of the earth. The only way...
So you're not for vegetarians?
Well,
that
no,
people just go
they can
total
be a vegetarian.
Veggie.
No, they can be a vegetarian, but they must supplement. It's the vegetarians who do not supplement are in trouble.
Oh, but wait, now, Doc, I saw on some of these programs where somebody has cancer or diabetes, and they reversed the disease with a vegetarian diet. Now, you're saying that's not really exactly smart.
Well, it's possible with a little bit of addition here. You ever hear a guy by the name of Jay Cordish?
No.
Okay, he was kind of the original juice man, and he had a terminal bladder cancer 60 years ago, and they told him he only had weeks to live and so forth, so he started juicing. And over the years, he helped literally millions of people reverse their cancers, but he began to put the minerals in the juices to guarantee that there was a level playing field, that everybody got the same nutritional value.
Okay.
Because a carrot grown, say, in Imperial Valley, California, doesn't have the same nutrition in it as in the Garden State, New Jersey. It looks the same, but one might have 13 minerals, the other might have 60 minerals. And so the only way to level the playing field is a supplement. Now, if you're a supplemented vegetarian, supplemented vegan, you can be very successful. if you don't supplement, it's kind of hit and miss where you live. Some places you can be very successful. Other places you're going to be an abysmal failure. Well, Steve Jobs' problem was twofold. Number one, he got the very best five-star vegan chef who cooked everything for him in extra, 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 virgin, 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 olive oil and coconut oil.
Right.
And he got pancreatic cancer from all the free radicals of all that heated oil. Got pancreatic. Then he made a second possible worst mistake. Instead of going to Costa Rica, which are where the longest lived people live in the Western Hemisphere, and going to the oldest...
In Costa Rica?
Yes, sir.
Why Costa Rica?
Because that's where all the minerals are at.
Really? I never heard that before.
Yes. This is in the Western Hemisphere of the Earth. This is where the oldest people live.
Really?
Yes. Did research for a book we call Immortality. We have the top 20 longevity cultures. Pastor Benny, they have 40 times 100 year olds we do. They have 100 year old per 250. We have 100 year old per 10,000. Just simply because where they live. It's kind of like the Garden of Eden in the Western Hemisphere. So, but you can take that information and bring it to your own home. You don't have to go there. So this is where Steve Jobs made his mistake. He should have gone there instead of Harvard.
Really? Wow. And the poor man died early because...
He died at 56.
And yet he was eating right.
Well, he was eating correctly, but again...
He missed what? The supplements?
He missed the minerals. You see, an organic carrot might only have 3 minerals. You need 60, and a vertebrate needs 60. And so he couldn't get all 60 from what he was eating.
Years ago, I decided to cut all fats out. It almost killed me.
Yes. And you're very,
and I had
God
to get,
loves you.
Huh? Yeah, God because honestly, I mean, I just cut all the fat out, just thought maybe that will help me. It didn't help me at all.
It could give you Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is a physician-caused disease, yes, sir.
Wait, Doc.
Yes.
Alzheimer's is caused by doctors, yes, not by diet?
No, no, it's physicians. Who told Americans to get on a cholesterol-restricted diet? Physicians. Who told doctors to take statin drugs to lower your cholesterol? Physicians. Well, I wrote a paper on that in 1971 and said, Houston, we have a problem. This is not correct. You're going to get all kinds of problems here. Well, what happened was people got Alzheimer's disease. They got low T, erectile dysfunction, because testosterone is a steroid hormone, 95% by weight cholesterol. So you go on a cholesterol-restricted diet. You take cholesterol-lowering drugs. Houston, we have a problem here. Then they come up with Viagra and all this stuff, right? But essentially, all you had to do is eat 6 eggs a day. And
they almost killed you on eggs. They said it's not good for you. Raises your cholesterol. The yellow is bad. Blah, 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 all that.
Pastor Benny, doctors only live to be 56, according to their own survey. Why would we listen to them? They say, don't use salt. They live to be 56. God says
use
salt.
You're funny, Doc.
God says use salt, and God is forever. I'm going with God.
God said use salt, but
yes.
Salt is still bad for your body.
No, it's not.
Well, a lot of it is.
No, it's not. No, it's not, sir.
Doc, I've never had anyone like you, but salt raises your blood.
No, sir, it doesn't.
What do you mean it doesn't?
It doesn't. That's a lie. That's why I say they bet on the wrong horse. The people bet on the wrong horse.
Are you telling me that salt does not raise your blood pressure?
That is correct, sir. It does not raise blood pressure.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
What raises your blood pressure then?
It's actually a mineral deficiency or kidney failure, one or the other. 95% of the time it's a mineral deficiency, 5% of the time.
How come nobody says things that you said?
Well,
I mean,
what makes me different?
I'm hearing new stuff from you. You've helped millions of people.
Yes, sir.
You've helped that gentleman with his knees. What was his name again? The mayor of Atlanta.
Oh, Andy Young.
Andrew Young.
Civil rights movement. Yeah.
Yeah. You rebuilt his knees. He didn't have to have an operation.
No, sir. He canceled his double knee surgery. He was already scheduled. He canceled it. That was 21 years ago.
And Creflo Dollar's daughter
got rid of her asthma.
You helped her with her asthma, yes. And now I guess she's cured.
Asthma-free, yes, sir.
She's asthma-free.
Yes.
I mean, I heard about this wonderful doctor from people. I said, because I never heard of Dr. Wallach. And I had him here a few weeks ago, and dear goodness, the phones began ringing here wild.
Another one for you. You ever heard of kidney failure, you need dialysis?
Listen, I know a young man in his 20s. Both of his kidneys stopped recently. I think he's doing better now, and it was a shock to me that why would a 20-something-year-old lose his kidneys?
Oh, eating fried foods, not supplementing properly. So I have a wonderful story for you. This is a God story.
Please, tell me.
There's a man by the name of Tug. That's his nickname, is Tug, T-U-G, like a tugboat.
Right.
He's 87 years old, and since he was 14, he hadn't urinated. He's been on dialysis for like 73 years.
Wow.
And we got him on our program for kidney failure. In 2 weeks' time, he's urinating. In 2 more weeks' time, he's totally off of dialysis. He's been on dialysis 6 days a week for 73 years. And in less than a month, he's off of dialysis.
How did you do that?
Well, this is a God thing, right?
I know, but how did God use you?
Well, we gave him the 90 essential nutrients. We actually have what we call the secret sauce for getting blood flow through little blocked arteries. Well, when you have kidney failure, there's nothing wrong with your kidney. That seems like an oxymoron or a paradox.
There's nothing wrong with it.
There's nothing wrong with your
kidney. Then why did it fail?
Well, remember, I'm a pathologist, and so surgeons would bring me kidneys they take out of somebody with kidney failure, and I'd look at them and say, these are normal. Why'd you take them out? They say, he's got kidney failure. Well, it turns out there's nothing wrong with your kidney when you have kidney failure. What happens is the little microscopic arteries that carry the dirty blood into the filtering units are plugged. So your kidney function goes down, not because there's anything wrong with the kidney. It's just the dirty blood is not being delivered.
Wow.
So we get the circulation going in the kidney.
I have a family member who they say may have to have a kidney transplant.
Probably not.
What do you mean probably not?
Well, give me 90 days and we'll see.
I'll call. And you can help him?
Yes.
He's a young man. He's related to me.
Huh? We do this thousands of times a year.
That you can prevent someone from having
a kidney transplant. We get him off of dialysis, absolutely. Because there's nothing wrong with the kidney most of the time.
Doc, put your hands on this Bible.
Yes, sir.
You promise that you can? Wait a minute. I've never done this on This Is Your Day. You're putting your hands on the Word of
both
God.
Hands.
And you're telling me that you can help this young man that I know,
yes,
in my family, where he doesn't have to lose his kidneys, or kidney right now, one kidney, with what you're going to do for him.
He has one good kidney, one bad kidney?
I think so.
Okay, that's easy.
That's easy.
This is the God stuff, right?
Okay, you put your hand on the Word of God, and you vow before God Almighty
absolutely
that you're telling the truth.
Absolutely.
I believe you.
Absolutely.
Wow. So what would you tell somebody who's watching? How would they find you, and how would you help them?
Well, I would have them come through the website of your program here.
Okay.
And they can contact me through you.
Okay.
Okay, because you and I are both instruments of God, and so they'll be able to find you and find this program through you, and we deal with every disease.
I mean, I even had Pat Boone call me a few days ago.
Yeah.
He said, if Dr. Wallach helped
Andrew Young
with his knees, I need his help. And I think you did talk to him, I hope.
Not
a
yet.
A few days ago. Okay, well, you will, though.
Okay.
But the thing that's amazing is you've helped people like that, and now you're saying if they go on our website, they can find you.
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
You've helped thousands.
Thousands. And things like knees, millions.
Whoa,
kidney
stop.
Failure.
Doc.
Millions, yes, sir.
Millions of people you've helped.
50
with
countries, Pastor Benny. 50
with
countries.
With knees. So that
knees.
My mother had a knee replacement surgery. Are you telling me that you could have helped my mother?
Yes, sir.
Then where were you? Where were you 3 years ago? My poor mom, it took her forever to walk and get her knees back, you know, her legs where she can walk and all that.
Well, we can help her because what happens is when you get a knee replacement or a hip replacement, the disease continues to deteriorate the bones. And after a while, that artificial joint they put in there begins to wallow around in there and cause more pain. They say, well, we got to redo it now. They say these things will
last. Yeah, it's actually happening now to her.
Well, we can fix that so that bone will grab.
But she's 80.
Doesn't matter.
3 years old.
Just like Tug, he's 87 years old, and he was on dialysis for 73 years. And in a month's time, we got
Doc,
him off dialysis.
Doc, are you for real?
Well,
I know you're real because you're here, but I mean, look, you know, I've heard so many people who've been helped by this man. Mm-hmm. That's why I actually have him here. Why would I have a doctor here if he's not, he hasn't helped people, and you have.
You know, God has never failed me.
You know what? I believe you.
God has never failed me.
Now, tomorrow we're going to talk about diabetes.
Okay.
And heart disease that's striking people left and right.
Easy stuff.
Easy stuff, you
yes,
say.
Sir. We know how to get rid of and prevent diabetes 70 years ago. This is very easy.
Doc, I am 61, okay?
A mere child.
Thank you. I appreciate that very, very much. Give me a five, Doc. What must I do, just before we say bye, what must I do to prevent myself from getting some heart problem? Just eat right or what?
No, sir. Well, eating right is part of it. That stops the ongoing damage. But then you have to supplement with the 90 essential nutrients take the secret sauce for your heart, your arteries.
Now, what is that secret sauce?
Well, it's the same thing that gets the blood flowing through the little blocked arteries in the kidneys.
Can you talk about that tomorrow?
Yes, sir.
Now, it's all in your book, too, and so on.
But, yes, sir, absolutely.
But one more time, what is it?
Well, it's a series of minerals that are required to keep the heart going, to prevent it. See, there's all kinds of heart attacks, and none of them have anything to do with cholesterol. Cholesterol is a total lie. It's the biggest fraud ever perpetuated against the people.
Really? Yes. Even high cholesterol?
High cholesterol just means you're sexy. Because you get to make more sex hormones.
Funny. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't expect that kind of answer.
Well, as God is my witness.
Okay, I believe you. But I mean, when they have high cholesterol.
Did Jesus ever say, don't eat eggs?
No.
Okay. Well, there you go.
But I mean.
I'm going with Jesus.
Back to. Hope I can finish this program. Back to cholesterol. High cholesterol means nothing?
Means nothing. See, in fact, February 2012, the FDA sent an email to every doctor in America, says stop telling people to take cholesterol-lowering drugs.
Wow.
Because it increases your risk of Alzheimer's disease by 100%, type 2 diabetes by 50%.
Yeah, and now they you know, there's that new medicine that they want people to take that reduces cholesterol and all the stuff. And
stay
you
away
said,
from it.
Yeah.
Do not take it. Fire your doctor. Bet on God, don't bet on the doctor.
Well, listen, I think we're all finding out for ourselves that we need to take charge of our own health, because doctors disagree with each other so much, they confuse you so much, and when they tell you what drug to take, they tell you these side effects that can kill you.
Pastor Benny, they never take their own drugs.
But we must say, doctors have helped a lot of good people. There's a lot of wonderful doctors out there that have helped a lot of good people.
That's true. But
what?
Well, I think the way to make doctors all good is we should test them every time they go into the hospital for, you know, to start their work day. They should have a urine test and a breathalyzer test, just like they do for athletes that win gold medals. Every day when they go in, and after lunch, they should do it.
Well, I would say they've helped a lot of people, because look at the good surgeries they've done, the surgeons
yeah,
and so on.
The
wonderful
room.
People out there. But I agree in many cases, you know, we haven't been helped because we have not taken charge of our own health and life. And I think it's time to say, okay, it's my body, it's my life, it's my future. I want to take care of it myself and make sure I eat right and know what to do with it.
But that's not enough.
Well, that's why you're here, to also help us with the what else can we do with when you say it's not enough. Okay, now, how will your book help people? Now, your book and CD. Now, your CD, you said millions have been helped.
200 million people have listened to that CD.
What's on it?
That teaches you, and there's tracks on there. You can pick, you don't have to listen to the whole thing. You just go to diabetes, you go to arthritis, you go to Alzheimer's disease. It tells you what to do for each of those diseases. Then if you're interested, you can go back and listen to the beginning. The book, Dead Doctors Don't Lie, covers over 400 diseases in the appendix, alphabetical order.
So this will show you what? The book will show you what?
What to do for just about any disease you can think of in the appendix.
How to fix it.
Yes, sir. How to prevent it, how to fix it.
So they don't have to talk to you. They can just read this.
They could read that. They don't have to talk to me.
Now, your products are also quite popular. So
yes, sir.
If you want to know more about this wonderful Dr. Wallach, then go on our website, and there's more information for you about the doctor and how you can get hold of him and a whole lot more. But listen, just before we say bye, really, how will this help? How will the book help people? Like what?
Well,
someone who's dying with cancer.
Well, it's a type of revelation, Pastor Benny, because what it does is it teaches people that they really have the answers at their fingertips. Again, they bet on the wrong horse when they went to a doctor. A doctor may have done a wonderful job in taking the cancer out. Then he sends you home, and he doesn't tell you to change everything that got you to have the cancer. You got to change everything. You have to change your lifestyle.
But now, Doc, someone who's been told they have stage 4 cancer and a month to live, can you help them?
Most of the time, not every time, but most of the time we can help them. Certainly we can give everybody a better quality of life. And let's say they say you got 6 months to live. What if they live 2 years? What if they live 5 years? And so, and certainly the better quality of life.
My father-in-law, dear Roy Harden, passed away in July. He was the picture of health in March, and he was gone by July. Could you have helped him had we discovered he had cancer in March?
Yes, sir. because if he died that fast when they discovered it in March, the treatment killed him. The treatment killed him.
Wow.
And so it's a matter of saying, okay, if I only have a month to live, I'd rather spend my time in my bed with my dog on my lap and hugging my grandchildren than being in the hospital, being treated with an experimental drug and dying by myself.
He's in glory now, so he's in a much better place. Yeah. But listen, let's help precious saints to live longer so they can do more for the Lord.
Bless you.
Get this, absolutely. Well, that's why we're talking today, and that's why you're here, Doc, and I'm glad you came back. God bless you. Help us in 2014 to live healthy.
That's our goal.
Amen. Call the number on the screen and get this book and CD for a gift of $40. Invest in your health. Listen, this doctor is for real, okay? Because the people that he has mentioned are not a fabrication of his mind. He really has helped them. And he's quite well known. He's quite famous. How long have you been in this?
35 years, sir.
Okay. Well, that's proof right there. Tomorrow, a whole lot more. And, wow. God bless you, Doc.
Well, thank you for being with me. God bless you.
I'll see you again, sweet saints, tomorrow.
And proclaiming Jesus as Savior and Healer.
Dr. Wallach is back, and I'm telling you, he is something else. I had him lay his hands on my Bible yesterday and vow that everything he says is truth, and you did. You want to do it again?
Yes, sir, both hands, not one, both
this
hands.
This is how I'm going to start the program, okay. That you're absolutely going to tell me the truth and nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
Help you God. You know, we're talking about health, nutrition, and how many people he's helped. Andrew Young, the mayor, former mayor.
And also, he was the ambassador to the United Nations under Jimmy Carter.
Right, and you helped him with his knees where he didn't lose.
He canceled his double knee replacement surgery.
Creflo Dollar, his
daughter.
His daughter is now
asthma-free.
She's free from asthma.
For 10 years, yeah.
Because of you.
Yes, sir.
And other people you've helped.
Actually, it's God's.
Of course, it's the Lord, but he used you. You're his instrument. And through how? What did you do to these people? How did you help Andrew Young, and how did you help Creflo's daughter and all the people you're helping?
Well, both arthritis, Pastor Benny, and asthma are both nutritional deficiency diseases. Doctors will tell you that arthritis is genetic, it's in your family, and if they can't find anybody in your family who has it, doesn't your dog have arthritis? They're always looking for some way to, you know, associate with your family. But arthritis, 95% is due to just simple mineral deficiencies. That's osteopenia, osteoporosis, osteoarthritis, degenerative arthritis, bone-to-bone arthritis, all mineral deficiencies. Rheumatoid arthritis is a simple infection with a bug called mycoplasma. I can cure that disease, rheumatoid arthritis, in 2 weeks with an antibiotic called minocycline. I'll kill that bug, then it'll take several months, maybe 2 months, to rebuild all the damage.
How come other doctors don't say what you're saying?
Because they'll only make $300 if they cure you. If they treat you, they make $750,000 over 25 years. Why would they want to make $300 when they can make $750,000? Because there's no law requiring them to cure you when there's a cure available.
So they give you medication?
Yes, sir. Unfortunately, that's the truth. Now, as you say, individually, they may be wonderful people, but the system captures them. If they don't do what the system says to do, they kick them out and say, I've gone to school all these years, why would I go against the system? And so that's part of the problem. And so people have to actually take some control here of their own destiny, their health, and their faith.
And that's, I think, what we need to decide in 2014, this year, to take charge of our own health.
Yes, sir.
And do it right.
Yes, and that'll make the difference. And that's what Andrew Young did. He canceled a double knee replacement surgery. He canceled it. I
mean, but he gave you a chance to...
He gave me 90 days. He said, I'll do your thing for 90 days.
And what did you do? How did you help him?
Well, I gave him the basic 90 essential nutrients, which we all need. You can't guarantee you're going to get it from your food, no matter how people say, I eat well, but that's not enough.
So you gave him 90
essential nutrients, 60 minerals, 16 vitamins, 12 essential amino acids, 3 essential fatty acids. And then I gave him what we call the secret sauce that's designed to support and promote repair of cartilage, ligaments, tendons, connective tissue, all the stuff that makes up the joints of your knees and your hip and your shoulder and the disc between your vertebrae. And even in July, I thought that was fascinating, even in July of 2002, Harvard Medical School came out, published in the New England Journal of Medicine, and said joint replacement is useless, is worthless.
Wow. Really? They actually said that?
Oh, yes, sir. And 4 years later, in the Journal of the American Medical Association, they came out and said, don't waste your time doing back surgery for low back pain and sciatica. That was Harvard again, the Journal of the American Medical Association.
Why do they keep changing their minds?
Well, because they did what's called a meta-study. They looked at 300,000 people from all over the earth that had had joint replacements and back surgeries. And in every case, over a long time, it never worked.
Okay, now you also talked about dementia.
Yes, sir.
One more time, 65% of...
Well, first of all, you have to understand...
Because he had said that before we began taping the program.
Yes, well, first of all, people have to understand, Pastor Benny, that Alzheimer's is a physician-caused disease. Now, there's four different dementias. Vascular dementia.
Doc, repeat that, really.
Alzheimer's disease is a physician-caused disease.
Because?
Okay, well, Alzheimer's disease is a going away of the white matter of the brain, the myelin. The naked nerve fibers all tangle up and they short circuit and give you what's called Alzheimer's disease. Well, this myelin is 100% cholesterol. So when you go on a cholesterol-restricted diet, and then you make it worse by taking a cholesterol-lowering drug, it's kind of like saying, stay out of the sun, do not eat any egg yolks, do not take any vitamins and minerals, put sunblocker on, wear big brim hats and gloves and long sleeve shirts in the moonlight so you don't get skin cancer. You're not going to give it. Right now, you know the most terrible disease raging in young people in the industrialized world, including America?
Yes.
Is rickets. It's a vitamin D3 deficiency. We learned that 200 years ago. Suddenly now it's coming back in America and Europe because everybody's following the doctor's advice of staying out of the sun. Don't take vitamins.
Yeah, because they're afraid to get, you know, skin cancer. Yeah.
Well, if you do everything right, you won't.
Like what? Do I mean, like
take,
what?
Take
right.
All your nutrients. You have to supplement with all.
So you can lay in the sun all you want?
Well, I wouldn't say all you want. You don't want to get burnt.
Oh, of course. You but I choose. Mean, still, you can lay in the sun without the fear.
Yes, of cancer.
Of getting cancer if you do what?
Okay, supplement probably. For instance, in Australia, which has the highest rate of skin cancer because they have no ozone layer there.
Right.
There's a big hole. They have the highest rate of skin cancer. By taking one mineral, you can reduce your risk of skin cancer by 60% just by taking one mineral.
That's amazing.
Yeah. But doctors don't pay attention to that because they're more interested in the surgery and the chemotherapy and the radiation, that kind of stuff.
And the Alzheimer's?
Well, Alzheimer's disease is one of four dementias.
Okay.
The most common one is called vascular dementia, which is where you get the blood obstructed to your brain. Your arteries get clogged in your brain, just like the same thing that clogs your arteries in your heart and your kidneys. Eating free radicals, fried foods, processed meats, oils, meat cooked too well done, that kind of stuff.
I actually saw this on a program this morning where it said fried foods actually don't, you know, they don't help you with that. That they actually can cause that.
That's right. Clogs your arteries. It's not cholesterol. It's fried foods.
No, with the dementia. Yeah.
That's right. And then you have what's called Korsakoff syndrome, which looks like Alzheimer's disease, but it was actually caused by a deficiency of a single vitamin. It was discovered by a Japanese naval surgeon in the late 1700s. Mm. You take this one vitamin, it goes away. And I've cured people who were designated as having Alzheimer's disease, terminal Alzheimer's disease, for 8 years, Pastor Benny.
My goodness.
And in 1 week's time, they get dressed, they walk out perfectly normal after just 1 week of being on these supplements. Because they had Korsakoff syndrome.
1 week.
1 week, yes, sir. And these are people who are unconscious, totally unresponsive. And they had to be fed through the G-tube, these vitamins. And in 1 week, they get dressed, get up, and walk out perfectly normal. And then there's Wernicke-Korsakoff, which is MS, multiple sclerosis, and this vitamin deficiency. And then there's Alzheimer's disease, which is a cholesterol deficiency, which is a physician-caused disease.
But you said 65% can be reversed.
Well,
you said that earlier.
Vascular dementia, Korsakoff syndrome, Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome, very rapidly reversed. Alzheimer's disease takes longer, might take 6 months to a year, depending on how much damage is in there. In the earliest of stages, it can happen fairly quickly. And of course,
but you can reverse it, though.
It has been reversed, yes. I mean, not 100% of the
time. Yeah, of course, but I mean, it's reversed anyway.
Yes, yes, yes.
And how do you do that? With the same, these minerals and nutrients?
You have to stop the ongoing damage, which means you have to start eating 6 to 10 eggs a day, poached with soft yolks. You have to stay away from all the things that cause free radical
damage. And that does not harm you to take that many, to eat that many eggs.
There was actually a case reported out of Harvard Medical School. It was the New England Journal of Medicine. Came out. I use this in my lecture a lot of times. The doctor came out and he had to rerun this guy's cholesterol. It was perfectly normal. And he says, well, what are you're 75, 80 years old. What do you attribute every one of your numbers in your blood test is normal. What do you attribute it to? He says, I ate 25 eggs a day. He says, what? I ate 25 eggs a day. I've been eating 25 eggs a day for 30 years. This is published in the New England Journal of Medicine. This guy is 25. So I always tell my patients, Pastor Benny, I want you to eat 10 to 12 eggs a day. You can eat 25 if you want to, but don't eat any less than 10 to 12.
Really? And that will help them?
It'll help you get rid of Alzheimer's disease, help you prevent getting Alzheimer's disease.
I've never heard that. That's amazing. Heart disease. Let's talk about that.
There's not
prevention.
Pastor Benny, there's not a single heart disease that's caused by elevated blood cholesterol or too much bad cholesterol.
You said that yesterday. That was quite powerful.
That's correct. Well, let's see. The most common heart disease is congestive heart failure caused by a deficiency of a single vitamin. There's a pastor in Southside Chicago. He was on heart transplant list for 3 years. 1 week's time on this program, his doctors, his cardiologist, declared him cured and took him off of 27 prescription drugs.
Well, wait, and you put him on your program?
Yes, sir.
For a week?
For a week.
And you fixed him up?
Yes, sir. And it was his doctors that took him off of all his medication,
that.
Not me.
His own doctor said you're cured. You're fine now.
That's right.
What did you? How did you help him?
Gave him 90 essential nutrients. Plus, I gave him extra that one vitamin that causes congestive heart. There's a vitamin deficiency that causes congestive heart failure.
What is that? Can you tell me?
Yes, sir. I will, because you asked me. Because you're an agent of God.
Thank you, sir. Please tell me.
Thiamine, vitamin B1 deficiency causes congestive heart failure.
Really?
It's that simple.
Why don't they tell us that?
Well, because a doctor won't make any money. He'll make $30 for an office call if he tells you that. But if he puts you on the heart transplant list, Pastor Benny, he makes $250,000.
Dear God, I had a problem one time with my heart where it was skipping, and this doctor wanted to operate and electrocute my heart and scare the lights out of me. I said, no, man, I'm out of here, and I left.
And that's why you're still alive. Praise God.
Because I went to a doctor like you, and I said, hey, doc, they want to do all this stuff. And I don't want it. And the side effects with the meds they were going to put me on, I said, would be the worst. Mm. He put me on some nutrients and vitamins and supplements and fixed me up.
Well, did the doctor diagnose you with atrial fibrillation? Is
that he did.
Well, it's not a heart problem.
Well, he told me it was, but anyway.
It's not true.
He said if it wasn't one part of the heart, I would actually drop dead.
No, sir.
You know, some of them are not really very positive. They just tell you, well, you got this.
He's a used car salesman.
You're going to die if this happens. You're going to die if this happens. Then you got to take these medications, and here's all the side effects that go along. And I said, well, what if, you know, the side effects? Well, we just don't know. You have to. I said, forget it.
Well, atrial fibrillation is actually a back problem, squeezing nerves that control
your heart. Now, let's stop. Dog.
Yes, sir.
A back problem.
Yes, sir.
After all those years, somebody tells me that. Okay.
I bet you had a back problem, too.
I did. I did because
I was in a
crash. I was in a plane crash back in 83. Suzanne and I were in a Cessna, single engine. Mm-hmm. It crashed. And when I came out of the plane, my lower back just, mm-hmm. if you look on the x-ray, it looks like a little curve. And they told me that every so often I have to, like, massage it or whatever.
And how much time later did you get the atrial fibrillation?
Not long after that.
Well, there you go. See, it's a back problem that causes that.
Well, how do you fix it? Mine is gone, though.
You take the nutrients, repair the back, and it goes away.
And I did both.
Yeah, perfect.
Because but I was not connecting the back with it.
But you have to, because that's what causes it.
I'm glad I have you on the program. So a heart disease.
Okay, now there's four heart diseases. Congestive heart failure is the number one cause of death in adults in America.
Okay.
Deficiency of a single vitamin, thiamine, vitamin B1. And then there's cardiomyopathy heart disease, causes sudden heart death. You're just walking along, drop dead. You see this in young athletes all the time.
Yes.
Okay. A track star, a basketball player.
What causes that?
That's a deficiency of a single mineral. I actually did 1,700 autopsies on kids under the age of 10 that actually died of that disease. Cardiomyopathy heart disease.
Because of one mineral?
A deficiency of a single mineral, yes, sir. And?
I could ask you what it is, but I won't. Go ahead. Go ahead, because I want to keep talking.
So if we give all 90 essential nutrients to all our kids, and we actually have a sports drink with 100 nutrients, and including that mineral, we will never have another young athlete drop dead from a sudden heart death.
And it's all in your book, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And then the next one is actually called arteriosclerosis, where you get clogging of the arteries. That's not caused by cholesterol. It's caused by eating fried foods and processed meats and oils and that kind of stuff.
So fried foods and all that really are bad for
you,
as they
say.
Yes, very
bad. Okay. And then you get an omega-3 essential fatty acid deficiency. I actually sued the FDA over this one and prevailed in federal court to be able to
you
say this.
You sued them?
8 times, and I won.
Really? Wow.
And the one that actually causes, like, when you get a coronary thrombosis, you get a blood clot in the coronary artery, that's caused by a deficiency of omega-3s. That's not genetic. It's caused by a deficiency.
What's the best source of omega-3?
Well, if you eat salmon, you know, oily fish.
But a whole lot of salmon, I bet.
No, not really, not that much. You only need 1 gram a day, 1,000 milligrams a day.
You told me on the program yesterday that eating healthy is not enough.
That's not enough, sir.
Because you have to have the supplements.
That's correct.
Why?
Well, you need, see, there's no insurance policy that will actually prevent or cure disease. The only insurance policy you have is to take the 90 essential nutrients in optimal amounts because you can't guarantee you're going to get it from the food, no matter how well you eat. That's why billionaires, their average lifespan is only 66.
Really?
Yes.
They all die young.
That's right, because they eat well. They have the very most expensive doctors who say, now, don't you take vitamins and minerals. That'll screw up our medicine.
My dear mother has diabetes, and I nearly had an argument with her doctor a few days back because he will not let her take some vitamins because he says...
Fire the doctor.
It goes against the medicines, and it can harm her, blah, 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 all this stuff. You're telling me to just fire the guy.
Fire the doctor. Yes, sir.
I'm glad you're raw like that. You're really honest and blunt right to the point. Okay.
Fire the doctor. And basically, you know, the phone book is full of hungry doctors. And you say, look, my mother is 80-something years old. She's got diabetes. And I've just fired a doctor who says he won't let me give her vitamins and minerals. You will let me give her vitamins and minerals? No, you're fired. You're fired. You're fired. Yes, I encourage you to give her vitamins. Okay, I want you to treat my mother. And so you have to go through. Isn't it funny, Pastor Benny, people get three bids and three quotes when they're putting a roof on their house. Whatever their doctor says, they keep doing over and over and over, and they get sicker and sicker.
Well, because they have authority in their eyes. Mm. Doctors have authority because of the title, doctor, whatever. Now.
Doctor Death.
Not all of them, though. Doc, how about diabetes? It can be reversed,
yes,
even in an old person like my mom.
I don't care if you're 170 years old. If your heart is still pumping, type 2 diabetes is reversible. It's a single
And hers
deficiency.
Is type 2, so...
Easy.
How do you reverse it?
Well, again, she gets the 90 essential nutrients, and she gets the secret sauce, which are two minerals that have been proven.
Now, he's not going to tell us what the secret sauce is, I suppose, but it's fine.
Well, the government won't let me tell you that.
Okay.
So I have to say... This will support and promote healthy metabolism of carbohydrates.
At the end of the program, we will tell you how you can get this stuff. Okay, go ahead.
And so you take the secret sauce with the 90 essential nutrients, and it all goes away. This was 1957. We knew this in animals. We knew it for many years before that, but it was proven. And then the University of Vancouver up in Canada repeated it in humans and said, yeah, it's true. This is back in the 60s. Now, why don't doctors do that? Again, because why would they tell you to take these nutrients, which are God's tools, God's stuff, I call it, why would they tell you to do that and they'd make $30, $60, $80, $100 for office calls when they can treat you for 25 years for diabetes and then you go blind and you get your feet cut off and have heart disease and all this kind of stuff as complications of the disease. And so they've created a customer for life kind of thing.
Yes. Have they really found the cure for cancer in this world?
Yes, sir.
They have?
Yes, sir.
And why don't they talk about it?
Well, again,
because there's no money in it. Okay.
That's right. There's no money in it.
And there are more people dying with cancer today.
Yes, sir.
Than died even 2 and 3 years ago.
That's correct.
That's what I'm hearing.
Yes.
Is that true?
That's
yeah.
That's correct. Well, it used to be when you and I were boys, it was like 1 out of 10 got cancer. Today, it's 1 out of 2. That's actual government statistics.
Wow. And because of what?
Well, to me, one of the most interesting things was it was a big study that came out of the University of South Carolina in 1998. And they looked at a large group of women. It was part of the nurses' health study, 90,000 nurses over 20 years. And they had one little piece, how women cooked. They said women who cooked their meat, like roast beef, if they cooked it very well done, which doctors encourage you to do so you don't get salmonella and E. coli and stuff like this, they cook your meat very well done. Well, women who cooked their meat very well done, it increased the risk of breast cancer by 462%. Pastor Benny, I don't even know what that means, because how much more is there than 100%? You know, but if you cook your meat medium rare, you reduce your risk of breast cancer by 462%. But if you cook your meat very well done, you increase your risk of
you
breast cancer.
You told me that the last time, yeah.
Yes, sir. And so that's very fascinating.
And I thought it was the opposite, that if you eat rare meat, it actually is not as good for you. But anyways.
Well, it is. It's very good for you, because it doesn't kill you.
Learning new things from you, Doc. I like it.
Well, again, you have to go back and you just look at the time when Jesus was alive. And they were very simple people who believed in God. And they were the ones who rewarded. The ones who complicate things and give the responsibility to somebody else. That's why I always say they bet on the wrong horse. They bet on doctors.
Hey, Doc, listen, look at this camera and tell somebody who's sick, what must they do in 2014 to reverse their disease?
Well, they need to start getting bids when a doctor tells you to do something. Go to 14 different doctors and ask them what they would do, how much they're going to charge, and all that kind of stuff, especially if you've lost your insurance, right? Then what you want to do is take all 90 essential nutrients. So you're giving your body all the raw materials it needs to maintain itself. Stay away from all the terrible things, fried foods, processed meats, you know, deli slices, sandwich meats. Stay away from oils, margarines, mayonnaise, salad dressings, cooking oils. If you eat canned fish, it's fine, but eat them packed in water, mustard, tomato sauce, not oil. Stay away from gluten, no wheat, barley, rye, and oats. Stay away from that stuff. It's all inflammatory. It causes clogs your arteries, causes cancer. And then
the gluten.
Yes, sir.
It actually can cause cancer.
Directly and indirectly.
And clog the arteries.
Yes, sir.
Wow.
And contribute to Alzheimer's and contribute to diabetes, many others.
Keep talking to them, Doc. They're listening to you.
It contributes to birth defects. We can eliminate every birth defect in America. We can make America a birth defect-free country in 9 months. If everybody takes the 90 essential nutrients and stays away from gluten, we can eliminate every birth defect. It's that simple. There's not a single genetically transmitted birth defect.
And it comes from those nutrients.
It comes from lack of nutrients. The embryo requires all
those
nutrients.
I mean, you can fix it all with nutrients.
They're preventable. See, we've done it in the animal industry. And doctors said, well, that's in animals. In humans, it's genetic. What nonsense. What absolute nonsense.
You don't believe that.
Well, it's not that I don't believe it.
That it's not genetic, because often they'll say, well, it's because whatever, your daddy had it, so you're going to have it.
Well, Pastor Benny, it's more than a belief, because I've actually, in one project for the National Institutes of Health, it was called the Center for the Biology of Natural Systems back in the 60s, I did 20,000 autopsies, 10 million chemistries. The book, it's 1,200 pages. It's in the Smithsonian Institute as a national treasure.
Oh.
Okay? And so this is not a belief based on just belief. This is based on facts. This is based on hard facts. I don't think there's another pathologist who's done, in all my projects, it's close to 30,000 autopsies. Truly, 80% of them are over 454 species of animals from all over the world. But that gives me an insight. And the other, maybe 13,000, are from humans.
You've helped how many people?
Oh, millions.
When you say millions, how many?
Oof, it'd be hard to count, because a lot of them don't report to me. They don't tell me. And a lot of them would be somebody who would read the book and follow the instructions in the book, follow the recipe in the book, and they heal themselves.
And you hear from them.
Well, maybe sometimes they'll send me. I had to carry out a box today.
Well, didn't you have like a little challenge from somebody said, if this doesn't work,
yes,
I'm going to sue you or something.
Oh, it was worse than that. He said he would destroy me.
Destroy you, yeah. Yes.
This guy owns the third largest medical laboratory in America. His name is Jerry Murphy. He allows me to use his name. He had terrible diabetes. And so we're talking about diabetes. He had terrible diabetes. And here's a guy who's connected with the top endocrinologists, the top doctors. He's got his fingers on the pulse of the cutting edge of research when it comes to new drugs coming along for diabetes. And he was failing. He's already getting tingling in his feet. And he was going to have his legs
amputated.
And he
told you what?
He said, well, we met in a dark back room of a mom-and-pop restaurant, kind of like at 5 in the morning, so nobody could see us, right?
Goodness.
And he says, I said, why are we in a dark room? I thought, is he going to kill me? I mean, why are we in a dark room? He says, well, because I don't want anybody to see us together. I don't want me to give you any credibility. I said, well, that's fine. Well, he says, well, I'm going to give you 90 days, because our mutual friend here, Rich, says that you can get rid of my diabetes in 90 days. I said, I probably can. He said, I'll tell you what, I'll make you a wager, Wallach. I said, okay, I'm up for wagers. He says, if you can do it, we'll be best friends. We'll do some stuff together. We'll help a lot of people. Fair enough. I said, what's the other part of the wager? He says, I will destroy you if you fail. He says,
and you helped him.
I said, you're on, Jerry. And he freaked out. He says, no, you better be sure, because I'm keeping my word. I will destroy you, Wallach, if you don't perform. In 3 months' time, all his numbers were normal for the first time in his life.
Wow.
And now we're best friends, and he has a series of clinics called, well, I won't tell you on the air, but he has a series of clinics which only use our programs.
That is amazing. You've been in this for 30-something years.
35 years, yes, sir.
And he's 74 years young and is still going strong. And his book, listen, of course, he's back because you sweet people so enjoyed this doctor when he was with me a few weeks ago.
And if you want to know more about this doctor, now we will tell you more about these, you can go to our website. There's a whole lot more on our website that I'm sure will help you. Okay, Doc, what's in this book?
Well, first of all,
dead doctors don't lie.
That's right. Of course, their average lifespan is 56, according to their own survey.
One more time, why did you call it that? Dead doctors don't lie.
Because their average lifespan is 56.
Okay.
According to their own survey, which came out in 1999. And so I said, well, why would anybody believe anything that somebody had to say when it comes to health and longevity, whose average lifespan is only 56, according to their own survey? It didn't make sense to me. But in that book, it goes over kind of a little bit of a history of the medical profession and shows you where they've been tripped up by some of their own stuff. And then in the appendix, it shows you how to prevent and get rid of 400-plus diseases.
That's amazing. And this CD?
It's kind of a short version of the book.
Is this a DVD or a CD?
CD. CD,
sir. It's a CD, and you said millions have actually heard this.
Well, more than that, because we've sold 200 million of that CD there. There's been that many people. They figure that each CD is listened to by 10 people.
And you sold 200 million one.
It's in 12 languages.
Well, listen, you can get both today for a gift of $40 to the ministry. Help me take the gospel around the world, and this year is going to be fabulous. Divine favor is yours this year, and make sure to call. And you can go on our website for more info on the doctor and other products that you have. And Doug, thanks for coming. This is really amazing. Would you do one thing for me? We have just
anything,
a few seconds. Would you stretch your hands and pray? You're a Christian man.
Yes, sir.
Pray that God will bring health to his people.
Oh, Lord, we ask in your son's name, your precious son's name, Jesus, please, please get this message to every one of your believers and people who maybe are on the fence and they don't know whether to believe you or not. They need help right now, because they bet on the wrong horse. They've been failed. And so we know that the best healer, the best doctor ever is Jesus. And we just love your son, and we want to thank you for getting the message out to your people. Thank
Amen.
You so much. Amen.
Amen. Divine healing and divine health. I love it. Another great program tomorrow with another lady doctor. You're going to love it. This whole week, because you know what? I want to start the year with health, so you be healthy and live long in Jesus' mighty name. Sure love you. Bye-bye.
Dr. Joel Wallach's groundbreaking studies over decades of research have revealed numerous facts and truths about your health, which are radically different from what you have been led to believe by the medical community. These findings have been distributed worldwide through the material on this phenomenal CD, Dead Doctors Don't Lie, with more than 200 million copies in circulation. Recorded during Dr. Wallach's lectures, this CD touches on a wide range of subjects, including aging, heart disease, cholesterol, arthritis, cancer, diabetes, Alzheimer's, and pregnancy. In all, Dr. Wallach addresses 25 topics and engages in question and answer sessions with the audience. And his book is a comprehensive expansion of the material on the CD, with over 400 pages of information which can significantly impact your quality and length of life. You'll learn how to identify 90 essential nutrients, many of which are not available in food. Prevent and reverse 412 diseases with vitamins, minerals, and herbs. Reach your genetic potential for a long and happy life. Eliminate a major portion of costly medical expenses. Take responsibility for your health, and much, much more. Dr. Wallach's Dead Doctors Don't Lie 400-page book and multi-million selling CD can both be yours today for a gift of $40. It's not too early or too late to gain the knowledge and tools you must have to rescue and revolutionize your health and that of your family and loved ones. Call or order online today.